Here we have 3.3, solving a system of equations using elimination with addition. Now, in order for you to use elimination, what has to happen is that the two equations first have to be in standard form, which is this form. Okay, once they're both in standard form, then you can compare the coefficients of x and the coefficients of y. Now, in order for you to eliminate, what has to happen is that the coefficients have to be opposites. So in example A, I notice that I have 3x and negative 3x. 3 and negative 3 are opposite coefficients, which means that if I were to add these two equations together, these would eliminate the x variable. 3x minus x basically cancels the x's out, and then negative 8y plus 13y becomes 5y positive, and 7 plus a negative 17 becomes negative 10. And then you can divide by 5 on both sides and find that y is equal to negative 2. And then how do you find x? You can plug that negative 2 into either equation you pick. Doesn't matter which one, they'll both give you the same answer. Plug negative 2 into either equation for the y, so replace the y with negative 2, and then solve for x. So here I have negative 8 times negative 2, which is positive 16. And then if I minus 16 on both sides, I get 3x equals negative 9. And if I divide by 3 on both sides, I get x equals negative 3. So what is the answer? The x coordinate is negative 3, the y coordinate is negative 2, and we're done with that one. It was already ready to go. Okay. Now the next example is not quite there. I notice that I have 4, negative 6. Now although these are opposite signs, they don't have the same coefficients. So these would not cancel in the elimination. However, you notice that here I have positive 1 and positive 1. So the values are the same, but they're not exactly opposites because they're both positive. What I can do though is manipulate either the top equation or the bottom equation. Don't manipulate both because then you're in the same situation. But I can manipulate one of the equations so that one of the y's is negative, and then it would cancel with the positive y upon adding them together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the top equation and I'm going to multiply the top equation by a negative 1. And what that's going to do is it's going to make this negative 4x, it's going to make this negative y, and it's going to make this negative 17. Because I did the same thing on both sides of the equation, this new equation is equivalent to the original equation. So I am perfectly allowed to use an equivalent equation to solve this system. Now that these are together, I'm going to put my plus sign. Negative 6x plus negative 4x is negative 10x. Here the positive y and the negative y will cancel. And negative 23 plus negative 17 is going to give me negative 40. If I divide both sides by negative 10, I get that x equals a positive 4. Then how do I go about finding the y value? I would plug the y into either of the original equations. I'm going to go ahead and plug it into the top equation, what was inside the bracket. So I'm going to do 4 times the 4 I found plus y equal to 17. So I get 16 plus y equals 17. And then if I minus 16 on both sides, I find out that y equals 1. So what is the coordinates? 4 for x, 1 for y, and we are done.